The mother, who lost two of her children to the Dreamworld tragedy, says there is no justice after its parent company was fined $3.6 million. Kim Dorsett can't believe Ardent Leisure got a discount of nearly $1 million for pleading guilty early.
A mother's anguish, understandably, still raw.
Four people are still dead. Grief and heartbreak just won't ever mend.
Kim Dorsett finding little comfort in Dreamworld's $3.6 million fine yesterday for negligence that led to the deaths of four people, including her daughter, Kate Goodchild, and son, Luke Dorsett.
The magistrate then say that because you fess up and say, I'm guilty, and four people are dead, we'll give you a discount in your fine.
The maximum fine could have been $4.5 million.
It's a bit heartbreaking, actually, to think that that's what four lives are worth.
Ruzi Aragi and Cindy Lowe were also killed when they were thrown from the Thunder River Rapids ride into the conveyor belt below. Repeated audits recommended safety improvements, but Dreamworld ignored almost all of the warnings.
It was such a simple correction that could have saved four lives.
I'll leave that with the court.
They tried to save a couple of dollars. They did not do the things that they should have done. The inspection, the staff training, right from the beginning, it was the penny pinching.
Ruzi Aragi's father says the only good thing to come out of this tragedy is the improvement to safety.
If they've gone in the way of stopping this thing happening in future, that is the most important thing.
Beirut Aragi and Kim Dorsett want the courts to set aside the $3.6 million fine for a charity to be set up in the victims' names to help disadvantaged children finish school. The Treasurer telling Nine News the government would be pleased to consider any submissions from the family about a lasting tribute to their loved ones. It won't end the heartbreak.
Nothing's going to bring them back, so nothing will probably give us peace at all.
But could go some way to giving their families closure. Shannon Marshall-McCormack, Nine News.